Hi guys, guys, I have very good news for all of you preparing for the prelims 2023. Guys, today UPSC has released the notification for the prelims 2023. Guys, you have got around 20 days to fill the form. The last day for registration is 21st of February 2023 till 6 p.m. So kindly fill your application before this date. Also, the prelims exam this year is on 28th of May 2023. So guys, you have exactly 4 months for the prelims examination. So it is high time that you start your prelims preparation in a focused manner, in a dedicated manner. Many of the students, they make a mistake that they start prelims focused preparation very late and thus they fail to crack the prelims examination. So it is very important that from today itself, since the clock has started ticking, you have to shift your gear of preparation to prelims focused preparation. Guys, here I can suggest you that you can make use of this 120 days plan. The plan has just started. You can see here day one, the plan has just started on 38th of January, just 1 or 2 days back. And we have started with the polity. You can see here it's a hourly plan. It's an hourly plan. Every hour what you need to achieve, I have given. And you can see here, targets have been given, and the targets include the static target, the current target, and also the CSAT target. You can see here CSAT target. Every day on YouTube, I'm coming out with a CSAT video for helping you, prepare and practice daily, prepare and practice daily. Now you have to go for preparation plus practice, preparation plus practice. Double P. Will lead to performance, preparation plus practice will lead to performance. Guys, you can see here after every after few days of covering that syllabus, we have a test. Like for example, after covering the NCRT polity, we have NCRT test. After covering the Lakshmikant, we have Lakshmikant test. After covering the governance, we have governance test. After covering the polity current affairs, we have polity current affairs test. So it is a very scientific plan, and if you follow this plan, you will definitely have high chances of cracking the prelims examination. Further, we have monthly current affairs test for every month along with the PPP of that month, which will help you to master the current dimension. Guys, you all know that these days, current dimension is becoming very important in the prelims examination. The paper is becoming more and more dynamic. And I must tell you that last year I was able to predict. You can see here on the website, you can go on the home page. I have written a blog how I predicted prelims 2022. You can see here most of the questions last year, I had predicted. You can see here the very first question, rapid financing facility. Directly it was from our notes, it was from our Optima cards, and also from the prelims power play. You can see here. So more NEER, you can see this question on NEER, nominal effective exchange rate. Directly, it was from our Lakshya NCRT test. So most of the questions, if you can see here, most of the questions we have predicted last year, and I am very confident that this year also I will be able to very close to the UPSC prelims exams. I will be very close to the UPSC prelims examination, and in the last 1 year I am preparing the notes in that direction and also the test in that direction, which will help you to optimize your last phase of preparation. Guys, what I am seeing that most of the candidates missing out is on the current affairs. There are many aspirants who do not read newspapers throughout the year, who do not follow current affairs throughout the year, and in the end they lose out. Particularly if you see from the environment section, from the science and tech section, many aspirants last year they have lost marks. But I just show you, last year all the questions from science and tech and environment was, you can see directly, you can see here, web 3.0 directly, it was from our full length test. You can see web 3.0 directly from our full length test, directly from our notes, directly from our Optima cards. So most of the questions last year, science and tech, you can see here qubits, quantum computer, most of the questions were from our Optima card and Optima test and full length test, and NCRT test also. I would highly recommend every one of you to follow this Lakshya test. There are around 60 GS1 test and 10 CSAT test. Along with that, I am giving you completely free, okay, CSAT mentorship as a part of this test series. There are around 20 to 25 lectures. Okay, plus I am also conducting current affairs session of last 1 year. Also, that is a part of this test series. Already we have started with geography. And guys, okay, I will teach you optional elimination tricks also. Last year, my optional elimination tricks have helped many students to, okay, maximize their marks inside the examination hall. Guys, I can tell you 10 to 15 questions in the UPSC, you can easily solve if your, okay, optional elimination tricks are, okay, good. And guys, recently I have released the Polity Optima notes and the response was phenomenal. Similarly, I will be releasing, okay, Environment Optima notes, okay, Economy Optima notes, Geography Optima notes, History Optima notes, and all the notes will be, okay, of the highest quality. I must, okay, tell you this. I will try my level best to be as close to the pattern of the UPSC, and I will keep the test also as close to the UPSC pattern, so that many of the things which you study in the last 4 months, many of the questions which you practice in the last 4 months, it will reflect in the examination. That is my whole, okay, goal. My objective is what? That whatever you study in the last, okay, in the last 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, okay, it should be reflecting inside the exam hall. If you are able to achieve that, then definitely you will succeed. The main problem what students complain is that, sir, I studied this current affair, I solved that test series, but nothing came from the material which I read, nothing came from the test which I practice. You can see here, Gucci mushroom, you can see directly it is coming from the notes. Every question, I must tell you, last year most of the science and tech question, most of the environment questions, okay, is the golden machine. You can see I have made an Optima card on golden machine. So most of the questions, if you see most of the questions, Miyawaki forest, okay, most of the questions, okay, were directly from the our test and our material. And this year also I will try my level best to replicate that. Yes, there are some sections like history, you need to, okay, like art and culture part, you have to, okay, read the NCRTs, old NCRTs, new NCRTs. There are some challenging, okay, part of the syllabus, but, okay, don't get bogged down because of the one small section of the syllabus. Okay, you have ample of scope to score in polity, you have ample of scope to score in economy, environment, science, but provided you do current affairs. Many students are not able to, okay, score very high in environment, science and tech, and economy just because they are not covering current affairs properly, and they are losing at least 5 questions. This means at least 10 marks they are losing out there. So this is for, the message is for all the students who are struggling to get around 70 to 75. Okay, see, I must tell you, I'll just show you this. Okay, what actually happens is that, okay, you can see this is, suppose, okay, what happens that most of the students, they are stuck here. Okay, which is 70 marks to 85 marks. They are stuck here. And you have to cross this 85 to 95. Okay, 85 to 95, there is a kind of, okay, many people, okay, are not able to cross this 85 to 95 barrier. Why they are not able to cross this 85 to 95 barrier is because of their, okay, not effective current affairs preparation. And that is why my focus is to help you prepare the current affairs in a very effective manner. Okay, so that in a very comprehensive manner. Okay, so I have prepared the notes in such a manner that I have not left anything. And, okay, I must tell you, one or two questions also can make or break you. I know students who have already cracked prelims before, but they failed in 2022 prelims because they missed out the current affairs question, like golden mushroom and Gucci mushroom. They have missed out last year. And I was very sad. Why? Because all these things have covered in my Optima notes, in my DPN note, but they did not know about them. But that's why I'm making this video to help most of the students who are, okay, preparing for the prelims. Guys, please read the DPN thoroughly, please read the Optima notes thoroughly, and please take regular test. Okay, because many students, what happens, they delay, and they start very late in the month of April, in the month of March. Till then, okay, a lot of time has already been lost. So don't be in that category of students. Take decision, start following this 120 days, okay, timetable from today. Start this timetable, okay, following from today. Okay, still we are okay. We are on the third day only. Okay, you can see here 1st of February, third day only. So now you can, if you start today also, you can take okay things in your command. Guys, in UPSC there are two ways to prepare. One way is what? Preparation, like you are drifting. You are drifting like a log. Okay, like means you don't have any plan. Some PDF will come in some Telegram channel, some YouTube video will come on some YouTube or something, and you are getting drifted because of whatever is coming in your way, you are getting drifted. Other is what? You have a concrete plan. Day after day, you have a concrete plan. How I am going to spend my next 120 days. You have clarity in your mind. Guys, success is nothing but clarity. Okay, if you have clarity in mind, what you need to do tomorrow, what you need to do day after tomorrow. Guys, I must tell you, 90% of the battle is already won. Most of the students who fail in the UPSC, they are cluttered in their mind. They do not have clarity what they need to do today, what they need to do tomorrow. And they just waste their time here and there. Whatever comes in their way, they start consuming it. Okay. So you have to be very prudent. You have to be very wise in what you consume, in how you spend their next 120 days. If you spend your next 120 days, okay, focused. Okay, focused. Guys, once Swami Vivekananda has said that, okay, if you take up an idea and live that idea, okay, every moment you have to dream that idea, okay, then every nerve of your body should dream about that idea. That idea will definitely see the reality. And similarly, in UPSC prelims, if the next 120 days, you are, okay, every second of your day, every minute of your day, every hour of the day, when you are waking up, you must be focused on prelims, and what should you do to get the prelims, okay, clear the prelims cutoff. If your focus is like this razor sharp, okay guys, no one can take away prelims success from you. Okay, success is definitely, you will get success in prelims examination. Just you have to be focused for the next 120 days. Don't get okay disturbed, don't get distracted for the next 120 days. Follow one concrete plan. Every day have a target for yourself. Meet that target. That will motivate you. So thank you guys. Bye-bye. Take care.